Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, brothers and sisters. In this video, I want to bring to your attention a conspiracy which all Muslims need to know about. This is the conspiracy to uproot Islam from the land of the Haramayn. In recent times, we have witnessed events taking place in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia which are un-Islamic and promote evil and wickedness, such as Riyadh season 2021. Riyadh season 2021 began in October and will run all the way to March 2022. It consists of over 7,000 events, including 70 Arab and 6 international concerts, in addition to 10 international exhibitions and 350 theatre shows. There was also the first edition of the Red Sea International Film Festival in Jeddah, which, according to Middle East Eye, was attended by a sizable number of world film stars from various European countries and Hollywood, among them homosexuals, feminists, and gay rights activists. We also saw the first 3-day Riyadh Philosophy Conference organized by the Literature, Publishing and Translation Commission at King Fahd Library in Riyadh, which was launched on Wednesday, 8th of December. This conference gathered an elite of intellectuals and personalities involved in thought and philosophy from Saudi and other parts of the world. The Chief Executive Officer of the Literature, Publishing and Translation Commission, Dr. Mohammed Hassan Alwan, said in the opening speech of the conference that Saudi is one of the countries of the world that is changing most, and no country could match it in terms of dynamism for revival. An issue which will have various philosophical, intellectual, and cultural overtones. Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman put forward in 2016 a reform plan under the theme of Vision 2030 based on investment and in the entertainment sector, among others. He announced in October 2018 that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia will be completely different in the next 5 years. He also said, "If we succeed in the next 5 years, the countries of the region will join us," adding, "This is the war of the Saudis and this is my war, which I am personally waging." Effectively, in the past 5 years, Mohammed bin Salman has killed off the traditional religious image of Saudi Arabia. We also saw the likes of neighboring Jordan join him through Netflix films, which were designed to corrupt young girls and boys, and through concerts which were officially immunized against the coronavirus to the exclusion of other social events. Saudi Arabia has also been joined by Tunisia through waging a war under Sharia rules and spreading poisonous films such as Black Medusa and what it entails in terms of debauchery and destructive feminist concepts. As for the philosophy conference in Saudi Arabia, the West's aim for recommending the inclusion of philosophy in the educational curricula is to poison and even destroy the Islamic personality and reconfigure the awareness among the youth and shape their thought according to those ideas that contradict Islam, such as making reason the judge of good and bad instead of the Sharia texts, and weakening the link which Muslims have to Islam and its authority, among others. All of this is to be pushed through the gates of openness to the world today and perceiving the reality of the world with tools such as the philosophy of enlightenment, which stipulates that reason can do away with religion thanks to science. This is to encourage Muslim youth to adopt the secularist and liberal democratic values and concepts and deny the authority of revelation, leading to eventually imposing a boycott on Islam, its values, and its history. This will also lead to accepting the corrupt reality, submitting to the colonialists and their imported thought, and to silently comply to the collaborating rulers and client regimes. As Muslims, we should be wary of what is being concocted against us by arming ourselves with intellectual and political awareness, mobilizing ourselves for the vital issue and the ferocious war against our Islam, and to repel the intellectual and military onslaught of the kuffar, which is threatening to destroy the Ummah and the future of our children with the collusion of her collaborating rulers. Mohammed bin Salman has set about executing what he had pledged to his masters in the White House, as he deems the war on Islam and its conveyors his personal crusade. And he is about to uproot what is left in terms of religious monuments and rites in the land of the Haramayn, so that he may be joined by the rest of the Islamic lands as he promised, and to follow in the footsteps of his partner, the Satan of the Arabs, Mohammed bin Zayed, who has turned the Emirates into a house of prostitution, debauchery and intoxicants, and who used, with the help of bin Salman and the rulers of the Gulf, the riches of the Muslims to fight Islam and buy the loyalty of the leaders, politicians, academics, media professionals, scholars and sheikhs, whose disregard for religion has led some of them to propagate and promote the events of Riyadh season 2021. In recent times, we have even witnessed the Imam of Al-Haram Al-Makki, Sheikh Sudais, sing the praises of the enemy of Islam and the Muslims, Donald Trump, and the treachery of other sheikhs lead them to side with the rulers against the masses, make their obedience an obligation, justify the carnages perpetrated against the Muslims in the Arab revolutions, legitimize treason, peace, and alliance with the usurping Zionist entity, and recognize its right to exist. Those corrupt and depraved rulers harnessed the riches of the Muslims to recruit spies, support their collaborators and criminals, destroy the Muslims' lands in the Arab Spring, and establish the projects of normalization with the Zionist entity. They, however, deprived the oppressed Muslims in Gaza, Kashmir, Burma, and the displaced women and children living in refugee camps of those riches, knowing that the plight of those oppressed Muslims is but the doing of the guided criminal and reckless policies of those rulers who blessed the oppression of the Uyghur Muslims in China and concocted an Abrahamic religion to efface the boundaries between Islam and Kufr and integrate the Zionist entity in the region. They also spent the funds of the Muslims wastefully on their luxuries and entourage and on those who promote westernization, liberalism, and the reformation of Islam. All this has been occurring within a frenzied campaign against Islam and its foundations, especially the prophetic Sunnah, which epitomizes the Islamic way of life in its political aspects and moral splendor. Brothers and sisters, the calamity of the Ummah in her religion due to the attack on its Aqeedah and the bulldozing of its values is tremendous, and her material losses pillaged for her enemies and their poodles in Muslim lands are immeasurable. Sincere scholars, parties and influential figures should spread awareness about Islam, its sanctities and the duty of Muslims towards it. They should infuse in the Ummah the spirit of struggle and standing up to the Kuffar Westerners, whose confrontation can never be through importing their way of life, consuming their culture, concluding alliances with them and mortgaging the country to their interests. As for those scholars and sheikhs who apparently support and legitimize the actions of rulers such as Mohammed bin Salman, they ought to emulate their predecessors, the beacons who made sacrifices and refrain from betraying Islam. If they are serious about supporting their religion and their ummah, they should get involved in commanding what is good and forbidding what is evil, which would be a warning to the traitorous rulers and regimes and deter them from conspiring and perpetrating falsehood. They should arm themselves with the assurance and promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who says, "If you help the cause of Allah, He will help you." They should derive their inspiration from the bravery and stance of the classical scholars and rely on the popular support they have amongst the Ummah. They are more than capable of overcoming the state of horror from the rulers by truly relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, the sincere scholars are even capable on their own to awaken those from amongst the Ummah who are oblivious to the plots, deceptions, betrayals, and conspiracies of the rulers. The sincere ulama are capable, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to lead the Ummah, seize the initiative, topple the kufr regimes, establish the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and resume the Islamic way of life if they re-energize their drive and mobilize the forces for it. Indeed, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the scholars as the inheritors of the prophets, so they must inherit the mission of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and be at the forefront in exposing and demolishing the plots and plans of the enemies of Islam, especially the conspiracy of uprooting Islam from the land of the Haramayn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Those who convey Allah's messages and stand in awe of Him and hold none but Allah in awe, for none can take account as Allah does." Jazakallah khair for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.